It's the CIA.
It's an army of individuals who have a license to kill. It's like Murder Incorporated, right?
Are you kidding? The CIA makes the mafia look like a Sunday school class. I mean, this is the problem with what's actually happening in Afghanistan. Look, the CIA has done in this country, what they've done to us is unbelievable. Look at the terrorist acts that have occurred. The CIA behind most, if not all, of them. We had the Marine Barracks. We had our embassy in Kenya. We had Pan Am 103. We had the USS Cole. We had Oklahoma City. We had the World Trade Center in 1993. Our government was involved in some of those. I can't say all of them because I don't know. But I do have documentation that there was government implication in some of these. And we'll discuss them as we go.
Well, Ted, the people out there, I mean you, did you know that the World Trade Center went up when it was bombed internally? That it all was put together by an organization called the FBI.
Is that this true?
1993.
Yeah. Yes, I have a, and I'll show this on camera, a newspaper article from the New York Times, and it was also an article in the LA Times, by the way, and it's dated October 28, 1993, and it's a result of testimony in the trial, and the informant, the FBI informant in the trial, a fellow named Salam, a 43-year-old former Egyptian army officer.
Iman Salam.
Right. He was the informant for the FBI. And he recorded his conversation secretly with this. So when it came time for trial, he said, hey, wait a minute. Here's what really happened. Now, he told the FBI in advance that they were going to bomb it. He was assigned, given the assignment to put the bomb together. And he went to his supervisor, FBI supervisor, and said, we're going to put a dummy bomb in here, right? And the FBI supervisor said, no, we're going to put a real bomb.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's name names. John Antisef.
Was and, supervisor.
Yeah, he was the supervisor for the FBI, and he winds up in the with having something to do with the Kenya investigation. So here's a guy who's involved in setting up the World Trade Center for blown up, and it resulted in the deaths of
six
individuals, over 1,000 injured,
$500 million. $500 million.
A lot of millions of dollars.
Millions of dollars, yeah.
And
in debt, property damage.
Right. Now, if justice were done, the FBI agent would be not only in jail, but executed for murder in the first degree. And is the chief suspect in the attack upon the World Trade Center on September 11th, is not the chief suspect the individuals or individual agency that bombed the World Trade Center in 1993?
Based on what happened in 1993, the FBI not only knew in advance they were going to bomb the World Trade Center, they furnished the ingredients for the bomb. Based on that, I would say that the FBI is the primary suspect, but also I think we have to consider the CIA. And the reason you have to consider the CIA is because when you skyjack four airplanes simultaneously with 19 skyjackers, that is no small operation. That took years to plan, number one, and hundreds of people had to know about it in advance. Now, our government, NSA, was monitoring bin Laden's phone calls in February 1998. Are you going to tell me for 1 minute that we didn't know about this in advance? The CIA had to know about it. The FBI had to know about it. The Mossad had to know about it.
Now,
MI5, British intelligence, had to know about it.
The CIA knows about it. The FBI knows about it. The commander-in-chief, the president, would have to know about it.
Of course he does.
And that would mean that, Bush had prior knowledge, and that would implicate him in reality, if we wanted to face this thing as it really is, in murder, in the first degree.
Let me explain to the audience what's happened here. Okay, back in the 80s, the Department of Justice proposed legislation to fight terrorism. And this legislation took away many of our constitutional rights and civil liberties. One of the authors, a female attorney with the Department of Justice, publicly stated, made this statement, I've got her name on my file someplace, that before this passes, people will have to be killed. Well, so that was the reason I feel for the 1993 World Trade Center bombing. Unfortunately for them, fortunately for us, the good guys, there were only six people killed, not enough to pass the legislation. So what happened is 3 years later, no, 93, 2 years later, April 19, 1995, down comes Oklahoma City Murrah Building, 168 people killed. 1 year later, the anti-terrorism legislation that takes away many of our constitutional rights and civil liberties is passed. And now with the Twin Towers World Trade Center episode, our Congress is now proposing further restrictions on our constitutional rights and civil liberties. These explosions, these terrorist acts, were an excuse to pass anti-terrorism legislation.
And then to implement it.
And then to implement, yes. And this is what's happening in the world today. And that's why our intelligence people are not only knew about it in advance, but probably involved. There's no question. You cannot possibly have an operation of this magnitude without our people knowing about it. Now, our government, the FBI...
When you say our government, and I got to challenge you. This isn't our government.
Well,
it's the banksters' government, because they control both political
parties. The government knows the what, where, why, and when, and how. And they had a FBI supervisor brag about this to somebody else, and it got back to me, of every patriot and every militia in the United States. Now, if they know that, are you going to tell me that they're not going to know about the terrorists coming and going? By the way, this operation, based on information that's come out since the attack, the terrorist attack, was planned in England, London, England. The training took place in Afghanistan and in the United States. And these terrorists came in and took pilot training here. And as I said earlier, Bin Laden's phone conversations were monitored, according to the press, in February 1998. Are you going to say they didn't monitor him after that? No, no.
Well, wait a minute, no.
The NSA, NSA employs probably 150,000 people. I don't know what their payroll is. I mean, it's the number of personnel. But they have taps on virtually everybody in America. This was part of the anti-terrorism legislation that was passed after Oklahoma City.
Well, that's exactly what Adolf Hitler did when he burnt down the Reichstag.
Well, why do you think...